haven't made a video on this channel in a while, but here we are. So let's do this. I think that I could do a lot better at this game than most people. I have never played this. So, okay, so okay, there we go. Okay. Whoa. I just gotta get used to the controls. Up. Oh, no, oh, no. Oh, come on. It's not hard. I know that. It can't be as hard as everybody makes it out to be. Come on. It's not. It's just a tree. It's not gonna be. There we go. All right.
There's no feeling more intense Whoa. Than starting over. If you deleted your homework the day before it was due, as I have, or if you left your wallet at home and you have to go back after spending an hour in the commute, if you won some money at the casino and then put all your winnings on red but it came up black, if you got your best shirt dry cleaned before a wedding and then immediately dropped food on it, if you won an argument with a friend and then later discovered that they just returned to their original view, starting over is harder than starting up. If you're not ready for that, like if you've already had a bad day, then what you're about to go through might be too much. Feel free to go away and come back.
I have not I'll had be a here. Bad day. Thank you, Ben and Fadi, for those.
All right. Thanks for coming with me on this trip. I'll understand if you have to take a break at any point. Just find a safe place to stop and quit the game. And don't worry, I'll save your progress, always, even your mistakes.
I'm sure you will. Come on. There we go. Oh, come on. That's not what I wanted at all. There we go. That's what I wanted.
This game is a homage to a free game that came out in 2002, titled Sexy Hiking. The author of that game was Jazuo, a mysterious Czech designer who was known at the time as the father of B-games.
Okay.
And B-games are rough assemblages of found objects. This. Designers slap them together very quickly and freely, and they're often too rough and unfriendly.
I'm sorry, Bennett Foddy, but we have to turn you down, my friend. Apply. All right. Alright, here we go. Up. Okay. Highest I've made it so far. Up. Oh no. See, a couple years ago, this game was huge. Everyone was like, oh, it's so hard. I don't think it's going to be that hard. I'm just getting used to the controls, and once I get used to the controls, I'll probably be able to speedrun this.
In a certain way, sexy hiking is the perfect embodiment. It's built almost entirely out of found and recycled parts. And it's one of the most unusual and unfriendly games of its time. In it, your task is simply to drag yourself up a mountain with a hammer. That act of climbing, in the digital world or in real life, has certain essential properties that give the game its flavor. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed. Some cliffs are too sheer, too slippery. And the player is constantly, unremittingly,
is not that big of a deal. What? No! No! What? Once you have the correct method or the correct equipment, or just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated obstacle in sexy hiking is worth it. It's okay. It's okay. Not that big of a deal. I can get back up there. I made it there before. Alright, I always say that people get too crazy with the hammer. So if I just slow it down, I'll be alright. Oh, come on. Okay, why is it that when I don't want that to happen, it happens? Okay. Just relax. Just relax. I have two children screaming in the background. All right. Here we go. Oh, come on. Don't do that. Oh no! Come on! I'm gonna move my mouse completely. Maybe that, or not my mouse, my keyboard, out of my way completely. There we go. Now we have all this room to work with. No! No! You're a deep frustration. No! No! Sorry, man.
What? Give him some kicks.
Okay, well, I'm starting to understand. Mm. Oh, what? What? No, I didn't do that! I didn't do that! I didn't do that. That was not my fault. It wasn't. Okay. Here we go. Let's try this again. What? No! Get on the house! I don't think I've said anything for the last few minutes. So if you've been wondering about the channel, Nuclear Nerds Now, we've been in kind of a hiatus. Some stuff has went down. Not really negative stuff. Ricky has moved away. He's recently moved back. But, you know, if he wants to explain that to you guys, he can. But, Brandon has, from what I understand, left the channel. You know, he's focusing on his career, and, you know, that's great for him. And I wish him all the best. No! God damn it! I mean, everyone is allowed to do their own thing, so that's what we've been doing. I've been working, I have a new child, he's 15 months old, his name is Dexter, he's ginger, of course. I've gotten married since the last time you guys have seen us. Back here. Yes! All right. Jimmy's been doing his own thing. Tommy's been doing her own thing. I mean,
the obstacles in sexy hiking are unyielding, and that makes the game uniquely frustrating. But I'm not sure Jazuo intended to make it frustrating. The frustration is just essential to the act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process of building a game about climbing. A funny thing happened to me as I was building this mountain. I'd have an idea for a new obstacle, and I'd build it. And it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. It already felt like my inability to get past the new obstacle was my fault, as a player rather than as a builder. Imaginary mountains build themselves from our efforts to climb. And it's our repeated attempts to reach the summit that turns those mountains into something.
No! No! But we didn't leave out of, like, a... out of any malicious intent or anything like that, or because we stopped wanting to make content. We love making content. At least I can speak for, like, some of us. Like... so making YouTube content was supposed to be, and always has been, just something fun to do. So of course, life gets in the way of hobbies, and that's fine. Oh, come on. Off of the
when you're building a video game world, you're building with ideas, and that can be like working with quicksand cement. You mold your ideas into a certain shape that can be played with, and in the process of playing with them, they begin to harden and set until they're immutable, like rock. At that point, you can't change the world, not without breaking it into pieces and starting fresh with new ideas.
Come on! Come on. Alright, I'm starting to get frustrated. I need to calm down. No, 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 no! Come on. Come on. No! What? I didn't even move the mouse! I didn't move the mouse! Understand the error of my ways, and it's time to relax. I can make it there again. I made it there before. Okay, that's not going where I want to go at all, but the show must go on. What? No! 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 Thank you for joining me on this episode of Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy. I'm not over it. I assumed going into this game would be a lot easier, and everybody was just making it look difficult, but the mouse mechanics... Yeah, you saved my progress. Shut up. The mouse mechanic is absolutely ridiculous. And anybody that says otherwise is lying to you. Like, period. So, thank you for joining me on this episode of Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy. Have a nice day. Bye-bye, everybody.